congratulations. Where does that rate for you in I guess, what you've achieved in your career so far?
Yes, it's incredible, you know, to get those awards and recognition. I think that the fact we've had such a good season and to be part of such a great team is sort of reward enough. But I suppose to get that recognition as a foreign player does mean a huge amount to me. But ever since I've come over with my partner Helen, we've been welcomed, you know, so much. So I suppose it's not so much a surprise to be able to fit in with the guys because they've been amazing from day one for us.
Did you ever think that you'd be the award winner of an Australian team?
No. I was lucky enough last year to get the Supporters Award, which was sort of blew me away. And to pick up two today, you know, in a team that's gone so well and worked so hard for each other, you know, is amazing. But I think that, again, it all goes back to what we've done as a team this season. I think that, you know, it's nice to pick up the awards, but it's more about what we've done and the journey we've come on as a side.
You've already signed on for next year, so exciting times ahead, I guess.
Yeah, you know, it's a really difficult place to leave. I had sort of one foot out the door earlier on in the year, which was, you know, it was going to be really tough. And then, you know, to be able to be a part of this for another year, and I think the journey we'll take with the Lions coming over next season is going to be massive for rugby in Melbourne. And I think, you know, with the squad we're putting together, we could be knocking on the door of doing some big things.
Where do you think you'll fit better next year?
I think across the board we're going to aim to get better. I think defence took a massive step forward this year, but we still finished with the, you know, I think the worst defensive record. So, you know, that's the most obvious one. But the level of trust we're building up over the past couple of seasons, I think it'll improve that anyway. And the work that John Muggleton has put into us this year will stand us in good stead.
Have you got captaincy aspirations? Obviously, filled in for a lot of this year. Is it something you'd like to carry into next year?
Yeah, definitely. It's, you know, it's been a huge honour to lead the team out, and we've had amazing support both in Melbourne and away. So, you know, to be the man that leads the team out is always a huge honour. But, you know, whatever the decision is, then, you know, be fully behind it. But we've got some great leaders in the team, and that's what made stepping into Sterling's shoes, you know, an easier job than it could have been. He's been fantastic for us, and, you know, we've missed him on the field a lot of times this season, but the guys have made my job easy stepping in for him.
Gareth, you talked about what a great season you guys have had, but I mean, I guess in black and white circumstances, you've won four games.
Yeah.
But is there still a feeling that you really have come a long way from last year?
I think so. I think if you look at, you know, I suppose the results against South African teams, the fact we're so disappointed not to come off the back of that tour with two wins, you know, shows that we've made a giant leap from being, you know, I suppose the plucky losers, you know, of last season. And it has been difficult. We've been, you know, ravaged by injury. We've struggled to put the same team out, or, you know, what you would have regarded as our best team at the start of the season. But through that necessity, we've built a lot of depth. And so I think looking at it from a whole point of view of the club, the journey we've made and the expectations that have come through, you know, that sort of takes the focus away from just the four wins. I think there were six or seven, we were within 5 or 6 points, and it's a case of next year taking that step and turning those into wins.
So would you say this year has been a pass mark for you guys, or still disappointing?
It is a level of disappointment. You know, we're all competitors. We want to go into every game and to win every game. But, you know, there is a sort of sense of realism that we're a new team. And from where we've come to move from bottom of the table, and obviously to lose that 12th place to the Blues on the final game was disappointing. But to go and push, you know, the Stormers so close, and, you know, to come within a whisker of getting a bonus point win away to the Stormers, you know, is massive. And I think at this stage in our sort of development, we need to take those small sort of victories and build on them. You know, there's no point in us getting down on ourselves and looking at it, you know, depressingly and saying, right, four wins, not good enough. We need to say, okay, we can turn this next season into a successful team. We're adding players, we're going to have some new blood. We're losing a lot of great characters, which is going to be tough. But we can turn this into a playoff team very quickly, and our development can be faster than other new teams that have come into the competition, because, you know, let's not forget, it is probably the world's best club competition, and it's difficult to get any wins. So, you know, we'll take what we've got this year.